Biodigester mistakes you must avoid when you are constructing a simple on-site biodegradable biodigester. In this video, I'm going to show you the 12 biggest biodigester construction mistakes you are probably making in your biodigester construction journey. I'm Jerry, biodigester constructor and consultant with 8 years of experience in the biodigester construction business. On this channel, I do videos that explain to you how biodigesters work and how you can use them as an option in managing your dream house. If you are new to this channel, you can subscribe and be part of a growing community of biodigester lovers. When it comes to biodigester construction, there are problems, and the problems are usually associated with mistakes that are not making your biodigester work effectively for you. This can lead to homeowners not being happy with the type of digester you have constructed for them, and then actually saying that biodigesters do not work. In this video, I'm going to show you probably the mistakes that you are making in your biodigester construction journey. Let's go into the video now. The first mistake on my list for this video is the fact that you are probably not doing a proper site assessment before constructing your biodigester. This leads to improper siting of a biodigester. That can lead to a lot of complications for your biodigester construction journey. You cannot construct a biodigester on a hill and expect the pipes to be run into it smoothly. You need gradients, one, and number two, you need a slope. Another mistake you are also making in your biodigester construction journey is not asking the homeowner the right kind of questions.
The number of toilet seats that you have in the house, where the project is located, what kind of soil do you have in your estimation is there. Most of them will ask you to come to the house and do inspection. But it's good to have a background knowledge of what exactly you are going to meet when you show up on somebody's project or somebody's site. It's good to ask the right question before you come to a conclusion whether this is a digester or this is a project that you can take on. And then the moment you ask the right question, you are clear in your mind where you are going to be and what exactly that you are going to do. So it's key for biodigester construction to ask the owners of the property the right questions and get the right understanding before you take on a job.
Not constructing the right size and type of biodigester for the property you are working on is also another mistake you are making in your biodigester construction journey. Constructing the right biodigester simply means that you are doing the right biodigester for the users of the facility for which you are being asked to do the biodigester for. When it comes to biodigester construction, each property and facility you are working on must have a particular type of biodigester you are going to construct for it. It could be a standard family size, it could be a large family size, it can be a commercial digester, depending on what you need site. So the next time you are constructing your biodigester, make sure you are constructing the right type for the right type of facility. The fourth biggest biodigester construction mistake you are making is not doing an effective and proper soakaway for your biodigester.
The soakaway pit is basically like a soakaway. It has to be filled with stones for the easy penetration of the wastewater. You need to consider the users and the lifestyle of the people who are going to use the facility. The key consideration here again is to ensure that it's deeper than the digester bed and has enough slope to let out the black water from the digester bed.
If you do a biodigester, instead of me doing a soakaway pit and attaching it to the biodigester, if the homeowner is willing to invest in a soakaway, then obviously everybody's problem is solved. You have done the block work, you have left some holes at the base. So let's say the water doesn't go, you have put a clean out on top of the slab. So in a worst case scenario, and the water is not seeping away, it's not going, you will just open it up and have that water pumped. Any excess water in the biodigester will immediately run back, do the soak away, and then that can all go. So that your biodigester works well for you. So any issue, you open the soak away, you take the water out, the biodigester is back to its use.
This biodigester construction mistake is dear to my heart. I'm most of the time saddened whenever I see it. And it is the fact that biodigester constructors are adding the kitchen waistlines to their biodigester soakaway. Adding the kitchen wastewater and the bathroom together with the sink to the biodigester soakaway is a big no-no. There are exceptions to this rule. If you are constructing it and there's no option for you, you can consider it. But if there's a problem, that's the place that you must go and look at, because that's probably the reason while your biodigester is failing.
When you construct a biodigester, one of the first key things that I will always say is to do a separate soak away for your kitchen and bathhouse. Kitchen and bathroom wastewater is not regulated. So it means that wastewater from the toilet room, the full flush units, are regulated. The reason why biodigesters work is because we separate the water from the human waste. So by adding the kitchen or the bathroom wastewater to it, you are virtually rendering the digester from working to its full capacity.
This next mistake in your biodigester construction journey is comparable to this scenario. You are at a hospital to visit your sick friend, and the doctor comes up to you and tells you, "This is a medicine I have for you. Take it and drink it. It is going to heal you." That's exactly what I'm saying when it comes to biodigester constructors banging their hopes on a bioenzyme. As I've said in several of my videos, the idea of the bioenzyme is simply to aid you in your biodigester construction journey. It's not an end in itself. Your duty is to make sure your biodigester is constructed well. If you do have a problem in the future dates and you cannot do anything about it, then you go in for the medicine, which is the bioenzyme, just to help you. You are not sick. Why are you going to be taking a medicine that has not been prescribed for you or has already been prescribed for a sick person? Bioenzymes are your biggest mistake you are making when it's the first thing you are putting in your biodigester. Another biodigester construction mistake you must avoid is to put a vent pipe and a biodigester. Biodigesters are simply on-site biodegradable toilet waste management system. They really work well when it's sealed and it's airtight. The biodigester does not need a vent to let in any air. They work in the absence of oxygen. Why on earth would you go and put a vent cap or a vent just to let the air out? You are not constructing a holding tank, which is a septic tank, whereby there's a lot of heat in the tank because the water becomes hot with time. Your construction is simply based on the fact that you let the water out through a system. And the biodegradation happens when the digester is sealed airtight. So the next time you're constructing a biodigester, avoid this particular mistake. On this channel, we do videos that explains to you how to construct a biodigester. And for homeowners who want to use the technology as a means of managing all their human waste. If this is your first time on the channel, go ahead and subscribe and be part of a growing community of biodigester lovers. The next biodigester construction mistake you must avoid is not putting in the right biodigester construction bedding material. The right bedding material is key to your biodigester construction success. Anytime you construct a biodigester, make sure you are using the right material. This biodigester construction mistake is a controversial one. You are probably not charging the right price. Yes, for your biodigester construction, you are probably not charging the right price. For your business as a biodigester constructor to be successful, you need to charge the right price. It means that for each type of biodigester you construct for a particular facility, the cost that comes with it is what you must look out for. It's best to be transparent with the homeowner or your clients about the actual cost of the digester than to be just looking for something to survive, because things are hard and we are naturally not making any biodigester sales. So the best thing to do is to charge the right price whenever you do that, the biodigester construction contract. The only way you are going to be successful in this biodigester construction business is by charging the right price. So you clearly state out your terms, you give the reason why you are choosing this particular digester for this property and why you are adding a soak away to it, or you are doing a simple on-site soak hole pit. You can also explain the reason why you are putting it in a drainage system, that's the gutter if it's available to you, or you are simply doing a small size, newly designed soakaways that I've shown you on this channel. Make sure in your biodigester construction, you charge the right price. It's going to save you a lot and it's going to make your business a successful one. The next time you are constructing a biodigester and you are deciding to put it in the gutter or in a drainage system, make sure you do an enhanced filtration for the biodigester. And that's the next mistake you are making if this is not what you are doing. Whenever you construct a biodigester and you are giving a direct line into a gutter, you need to do enhanced filtration, which means you need to do an additional soak away that will retain the water before the clean one goes into the gutter. The main reason is that toilet water is not allowed in gutters in Ghana. You do need a certification to do that, just to avoid all the problems that come with such a situation. whenever you construct a biodigester for a gutter, make sure you add an enhanced filtration to it. This biodigester construction mistake saved me and my clients thousands of Ghana cedis. And that is trying to replace a septic tank with a biodigester without meeting key conditions. Whenever you do get a business, a client comes up to you and say, I have a septic system or a manhole, it's not working. I want it replaced. Is there something you can do about it? There are certain key conditions that you must meet if you can really replace it with a biodigester. It's key for you as a biodigester constructor to know the key conditions that you must meet if you want to replace a septic system with a biodigester.
It's a channel dedicated to those biodigester lovers who are interested in how biodigester work and how they can use it as an option in terms of their human waste management system. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe and be part of us. This video will explain to you biodigesters how they do work, and then gives you the understanding, the disadvantages and advantages of how biodigesters work, and how you can use it as an option for your home when it comes to your toilet wastewater management.